What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. Yesterday we had a little bit of a problem with the server on the Slash. Go check out yesterday's video and I'll make today's video easier to understand. Yesterday the server went out and we went down to our local hobby shop, Viper Hobbies. They replaced it for free. They'll replace it for free in the first month of if any electronics go out. Huge shout out to Viper Hobbies. They are super nice, super helpful. I recommend you guys going down there for your RC stuff. This is the new servo that they replaced. And so they just take the cord, it goes through here, under, it goes through the battery tray and into here. And then what I learned when we were there is when he was putting this to the servo, he said with that screw right there, right here, don't ever use a power tool to put that in. You always want to do it by hand because you never want to make these too tight and then you could break a servo again. Also, while we're down there, they had this 2S battery on sale, 5,000 milliamp, and it was actually $30. So we got that there, and now we can charge a battery while we're driving the Slash. So we can have like endless fun. And then the 3S is over here on the charger. A little tip for your batteries is once you're done driving the car, most likely your battery is gonna be warm. And before you plug it in on the charger, what I usually do is I put it on a chair or something and stick it in front of a fan and let it cool down. Don't ever stick it in the fridge or the freezer. The guys at the hobby shop said that's not really good for it. So you always want to stick it in front of a fan or something, or just let it cool down before you plug it in, because it can ruin your battery while it's charging because it's hot from when you're charging it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. And stay tuned for more Slash and RC car content. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.